Hello, my name is Brian Kenyon with Maya HTT, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate how to make your own custom drawing template. In this example, we'll be using the drawing format tools provided by NX to make a fully automatic drawing template. Additionally, I will show you an alternative method so you don't need to create multiple templates. You can get the job done with just one. To start off, I'm going to go ahead and create a new part using the blank template. With this new blank part as my displayed part, I'm going to go ahead and enter the drafting application. Once entering the drafting application, the dialog box will ask for a sheet size. In this case, I'm going to use A0. Now that I'm in the drafting application, typically title block exists on a certain layer. Before I start adding anything, I'm going to just set my work layer to the desired layer I want my title block to be on. Now that my layer is set, I can start creating my template. Using the border and zones tool, I am first going to define the border. Inside the dialog box, we have many options to choose from, but I will leave these default and I'm only going to change the setting for display, sheet size, and border. As you can see here, my border has now been created. If I go ahead and change my sheet size, notice the border actually updates with the sheet size as I change it. I'm going to change this back to A0 for this demonstration. The next step will be to define our title block. Notice this command asks for some tables for the input. We're going to go ahead and create those using the tabular note. I'm just going to reference the standard template size. Although it is okay to deviate from this, it is a good starting point. I have seen some instances where people will try to create just one table and size it by merging rows and columns. This can get tricky. The Define Title Block tool actually allows multiple table selection, so you can actually create as many tables as needed. With that being said, I'm going to create a table for just my first row. My columns will be 4, and my rows will be 1. I'm going to change some settings in this tabular node as well. For the bottom row, I want the text size to be 3. Additionally, I'm going to change the alignment position to the bottom right to attach it to my border more easily, as shown here. Now that I have placed my table, I can actually start by resizing the column widths to what is appropriate for the different sections of text in my template. Now that I have resized all my columns, it is time to start applying text values to them. I'm going to start with the sheet scale. I have previously stored these attributes, but they can easily be copied from the Siemens template or found on the NX community sites. I'm just going to go ahead and paste that attribute here for the scale, and then I'll do my mass, and for the first column, I'm just going to use the text and keep it separate for the column that will actually host the mass value. Lastly, I'm going to go ahead and add the sheet number with the attribute, so when any additional sheets are added, this column will automatically update. Back in the column for the mass, I'm going to put a placeholder value in to make sure that my numerical value will appear correct once my attribute is applied. Inside the column settings, I will change the category from text to number and change some additional settings so that it appears correct. Now that I have updated the values for each column, I can go ahead and format them how I would like to see them. By first, I'll center the scale in this column. And additionally, I'm going to remove the center line between my mass and the actual value. I'm just going to go ahead and mark that as invisible. And go ahead and hit close. Now that my first row is done, I can go ahead and start adding additional tables to make my title block represent everything I need to put for the information. For this one, I'm going to say 5 columns and 2 rows, and I'm also just going to place that at the top of the other table I had just created. Now that I got my tables to look how I want them to represent my title block with the correct formatting, I can start adding some attributes so it updates automatically. I'm going to start with the mass. For this attribute, I will use the roll-up mass as best practice in NX to separate the drawing and master model file. Doing this adds the master to the drawing part, thus using the rollup mass attribute. Next, I'm going to start adding attributes for things such as drawing number, revision, and title. Although I'm not working in TeamCenter managed NX, I'm still going to apply the attributes as if I was. So here I'm selecting the drawing number attribute. the team center item revision attribute. And lastly, the part name attribute for my title. Now that that's all set, I can go ahead and add my finishing touch of the Maya HTT logo. I'd say this looks pretty good. So now it's time to define our title block. So using the Define Title Block tool, it's asking for the tables. I'm just going to draw a window over the tables we created. We can ignore this error because we did do some formatting into tables, and that's just kind of letting us know that we did. So once I'm in this dialog box, I'm going to go ahead and lock some cells that won't need to be modified when you actually populate the title block. But here I'm going to put the label as drawn by because that's what the value will be asking for when we populate. Same with the drawn by date. I'm going to lock some additional rows in here. And we'll keep doing this until we get our title block values that we need to input all set. I'm now going to go ahead and fast forward to where I have all my cells configured. Once all set, you can actually go ahead and hit OK. If you notice, all my tables are now combined into a single title block feature. And when using the populate title block command, you'll see the labels for each value we want to manually be applied. If I need to edit what is required to apply, I simply right-click the title block and use the edit definition to unlock or modify tables. If I use the edit table, this gives me even more flexibility to modify the tables as if we were originally creating them. I'm going to go ahead and hit finish because I'm not modifying anything. And once again, I'll go ahead and hit OK. I could now start defining this as my A0 template by doing a save and marking it as a template. But as mentioned, I'm actually not going to do this because I'm actually going to create one template that will work for all future drawings. To avoid confusion, I'm just going to change the part name attribute to not include the size A0. Go ahead and hit OK. And next, I'm going to just show the behavior as if I change my sheet size, my template will actually move with it. And you can see here that the sheet size value from the attribute actually automatically updates as well. I'm going to change this back to A0 to mark it as my template. But first, I'm going to go ahead and save this as a new part for my general template. And the next step will to be actually define it and mark it as a template to use. I could mark as a template and update the packs file, but I'm going to actually do that manually. This is just saying I need to save it. I'm going to go ahead and mark it as a template and then hit File, Save. Now I'm ready to add this to my packs file. I'm just going to start by going ahead and copying the part we just created, and I'm going to paste that actually in my install directory for NX. If you have an NX custom folder, you could add that template to that and update your custom packs file. But for this case, I'm just going to use the install packs file. I'm going to go ahead and copy this first metric A0 one because I'm going to change the values to apply to look at my general Maya template. I'm just going to change the ID and I'm going to change the display name to Maya General Drawing Template. I'm just going to give this a new description by basically removing the A0 size. And I'm going to remove any other mention of the A0 as well. Lastly, I'm going to go ahead and check this to make sure all my settings are correct. And I'm just going to tell this to look at the part file I just created. I'm just going to go ahead and copy the name. And go ahead and paste that in the value for the file name. I think all these other settings look correct, so I can go ahead and save my packs file and relaunch NX. With NX relaunched, I'm going to go ahead and open the part I want to create a drawing file for. If you take note here, I do have the mass updated, but we need to make sure we're creating attributes for the mass. So in my customer defaults, I'm going to go ahead and go to gateway, the materials and mass, and part attributes to create single part attributes for the mass. And I also want to make sure that I have my rollup mass attribute being created as well. All that's set, so I can go ahead and hit file new, and I'm going to create a drawing from the template we had just created. Go ahead and hit OK, and you'll see here that the first dialog box allows you to populate the title blocks, but I'm actually going to go ahead and just add views first. I'm going to place my top view and then a projected view from that. If you take note, I would say my sheet size is a little too big for this part, so I'm just going to turn this back to an A4 and adjust the views as needed. Since I'm not working Team Center integrated, those attributes did not automatically populate, so I'm just going to go ahead and rename those. If you were working in managed NX, those would actually automatically update for you based on the attribute value. Now that I have updated those, I can go ahead and hit OK, and now it's time for the mass. As you can see here, our mass is set at 0, but we use the component as an assembly into our drawing file. You could update this by going to the analysis, update mass properties, or you can right click the properties of the drawing file, go to the mass tab and say update mass properties on save, and also you can update them from here. And if you notice, my mass properties are now updated. And that is how you use the NX template tools to create your template for your company. Like I mentioned before, you could create multiple templates, but the idea of this one is just to create one template that captures everything. Once again, my name is Brian Kenyon with MyHTT, and thank you for watching.